Welcome back to Video Soul. At only 20 years old, this singer, songwriter, is being groomed for huge success and superstardom. She doesn't have that already. Her self-titled debut album has two singles simultaneously riding the charts, and the word has it that the best is yet to come. Please help me welcome the lady who can boast a 7-octave vocal range, and there aren't many that can say that. I don't know of any, really. Mariah Carey. Hi, Mariah.
Hi.
How you doing?
Good, how are you?
Oh, great. It's really good to see you. We've been looking forward to this day for some time.
So have I.
I mean, you came on the scene in a big way. You know, I was telling you before we came on that the packaging on your CD single, before I even listened to the record, just the packaging, I said, this woman must be bad because they put a lot of money in this packaging. It's got to be something good inside here. It turned out to be a number one song on all the charts. How'd that feel to have, I mean, a song that was the song? I mean, for that particular point in time, I mean, for all radio stations, that was the song, Vision of Love.
It felt incredible, especially because I wrote the song to know that people were enjoying it, you know, and getting something out of it when I put so much into writing it, and it's a very emotional song for me, so it was amazing.
Mm-hmm. What was the motivation for the song?
It's about sort of everything that was happening in my life at the time. I wrote it when I had just signed my record deal with Columbia, mm-hmm. and everything was going really well in my life, and it was a pretty amazing turning point, mm-hmm. and that just inspired it.
Okay. How did you get your deal?
Okay, I was a backup singer for Brenda K. Starr, and she became like my best friend, and mm-hmm. everybody who met me, she would say, oh, you gotta hear my friend Mariah, you know, she's 18 years old, she writes all her own songs. So she brought me to this party, and she introduced me to Tommy Mottola, who's the president of CBS Records, mm-hmm. and handed him my tape, and I never expected him to listen to it, or I just expected him to like throw it aside, but mm-hmm. he went out to the limo, and he put it on his way home from the party, and he turned around and came back to find me, because there was no phone number on the tape or nothing. So he just, he found me that Monday through her managers, and I had my deal.
You're kidding.
No, it was incredible.
I mean, that's like a like a movie. I mean, if I'm sitting in a movie theater watching that, I'm going, yeah, right. Seriously, that's a dream mm-hmm. at 18 years old. Mm-hmm. So it took, your album was released when you were 19, is that right?
No, 20.
When you were 20?
I recorded when I was 19.
Okay. Uh-huh. So how long did it take you to get together all the albums, or all the cuts for the album, or were some of the songs that you played for him that night some of the things that made the album?
There were 5 songs on the demo, and 4 of them ended up on the record.
Really?
So I had almost half the songs that I had written over that year when I was struggling and waitressing and singing sessions and backup singing and stuff. And then I just wrote the rest of it over the next 4 or 5 months, and we had the album.
Wow. Yeah. So when you were struggling and waitressing, did you ever lose faith that things would happen for you?
No, I just always believed that it would happen because that's the only way to, you know, realize your dreams.
Mm-hmm. Understand, you come from a musical family, mm-hmm. that your mother is an opera singer, is that
mm-hmm.
right?
And a vocal coach.
And a vocal, oh, wow. So, mm-hmm. so you had your coach right at home.
Mm-hmm.
So were you like pushed to that, or did you just naturally gravitate to singing?
No, I naturally gravitated to singing. I mean, they had to tear me away from the radio every night, and I just always loved doing it.
Mm-hmm. But now, she was into opera, but obviously you're into something far different.
Mm-hmm.
How did that come about? I mean, how did you not follow in her footsteps to opera?
Well, I have a brother and sister who are 9 and 10 years older than me, and we're always listening to Stevie Wonder or Aretha or Gladys Knight or, you know, some great soul singer, and that's just what I listened to, and that's what I loved, and that's the music that, you know, I gravitated towards.
So do you consider yourself a soul singer?
I'm a singer. If people feel that my music is soulful, then I guess so.
Yeah, well, they do. You know, and I got to ask you this, too, because you hear people ask all the time, is she black? Is she white? Is she, what, you know?
My mother is Irish and my father is Venezuelan and black.
Oh, is that right? Okay.
So, I don't know what that makes me. I'm human.
It makes you beautiful. And you are that. Mm-hmm. You are beautiful. Let's take a look at the video, the first one that really happened for, was number one song in this country, Vision of Love, Mariah Carey. Man, that's beautiful. Mariah Carey with Vision of Love. That one run you do it near the end is just ridiculous. I mean, it's like all the singers out there must listen to this and go, dang. She's too bad.
Thank you.
Mariah Carey's our guest. We'll be back to talk with her more in just a couple of minutes.